I'm Jovan, a good dev to all the members in BMS service family. So today I'm going to speak about a microalgal approach for sustaining microbial plant human life in space. So my main objective is to grow develop a phytomicrobiome system in International Space Station and simulated Mars regolith for sustaining life in long period space missions. So before going too deep, I like to explain some basic concepts on what is microalgae, cyanobacteria, and microgravity. So microalgae is nothing but a unicellular photosynthetic or non-photosynthetic eukaryotic organism. And cyanobacteria is a bacteria which has the capability for the photosynthesis, and due to that, it is characterized or expressed as a blue-green algae and have shown a good symbiotic relationship with the plants. And so we all know that gravity is a force of attraction, what we experience in the Earth's surface. So microgravity is nothing but that force of attraction became less, we experience a weightlessness or a gravity-induced free fall. And yeah, so as I analyzed 58 years of microalgae experiments that has conducted in different space missions from Sputnik 2 to SpaceX CRS-15. So they have shown some microalgae that can survive in space conditions, especially Chlorella vulgaris, Chlorella pyranodosa, Chlamydomonas reinhardti, Nostox sporidosa, Euglena gracilis, Cynodesmus obliquus, and Arthrospora platensis. And what is this space conditions? It includes microgravity, high cosmic radiations, vacuum, mechanical stress, hypoxia, extreme range of temperature and pressure, and perchlorates, which is present in different planets, soil. And these are the results. And I just explained a overview of all the experiments that have conducted in space. So the algae has responded to a positive approach to the different space conditions. And they have shown an increase in the cell size, cell density, and they have shown a high increase in mitochondria and also a high production of hydrogen ion ATPase synthesis that tells us a microgravity situation is an energy conceptive condition. And we have seen a biochemical change due to microgravity and especially a high increase in photosynthesis ability in D1 protein mutant strains. And this D1 protein is a subunit of photosynthesis system 2. And it uses protons for the oxidization of water to atmospheric oxygen. And this microalgae have shown an increase in carbon dioxide absorption and high oxygen production, which is good. And it can alter the atmospheric conditions. And due to different stress responses, like wide range of pressure, they have shown a high regulation in production of the glycerol and sucrose to maintain the inner balance. And due to high radiation, this microalgae have shown the production of biofilm to entrap the UV radiation and surviving from that situation. And due to high radiation, there are genetic alteration. And the interesting thing is that the microalgae, by using the DNA repair pathway, in 24 hours, they have repaired it and without changing a 90 to 95% of the photosynthesis capacity. And by understanding the positive effects shown in microgravity conditions and space conditions, researchers have understood like why not we can use this microalgae to make a connection with the human survival. And they have incorporated a photobioreactor which is used for the cultivation of algae with the association of environmental control life support system where the astronomers grow live. And and the mechanism of this biological life support system is we apply a light source and high temp- uh, like normal temperature, and they absorb the carbon dioxide from the astronauts, and they produce oxygen. So from that oxygen, astronauts sleep, and after the cultivation of microalgae, the cultivator microalgae is used as a food source. And in part three, we can see that the waste from the astronaut is consumed of microalgae and can be used to production of water, and the cycle is repeated. And an interesting fact is that in light source, in ISS, they use a blue photon or blue LED for the increasing the growth of the cell, and red photon to induce the enhanced cell. And yeah, so coming to this slide, I will be speaking about the microbial ecological life support system, MELESA. So it is a basic model of high plant and cyanobacteria interaction, which helps the humans to survive in space. And the main goal of MELESA is to utilization of the urine and carbon dioxide to produce the food and oxygen, and air and water recycling. And the MELESA works like there are four compartments and one compartment extra for the higher plants. And in first compartment, the waste are collected and it is anaerobically converted into ammonia and especially volatile fatty acids. And these volatile fatty acids are removed in the secondary compartment. And this ammonia, when goes to the third compartment, it is reduced by chemosynthetic bacteria to nitrate, and nitrate to the nitrous oxide. So this breakdown gives the nitrogen source to the higher plants and cyanobacteria. And this higher plants and cyanobacteria will produce biomass, and this can be used as food source for the crew. And this microalgae and plants symbiosis will help for the revitalization of the air and also the cleaning of the water. And okay, so this is a theoretical, not a theoretical concept, but it's in a research process actually. So it's a cyanobacterial based biological life support system on Mars regolith. And in different researches already happened in simulated Mars regoliths. So I will be explaining how the cyanobacteria will be acting in soil environment in Mars, especially like simulated Mars regolith. So as we all know, in Mars, there is a high amount of carbon dioxide, nitrogen, and low amount of oxygen is there. And this cyanobacteria can use any type of source, and they can survive in any by utilizing any different sources, like inorganic sources, or utilization of the high energy or photons. And this Mars soil has a lot of nutrients, such as carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, etc., and micronutrients, especially molybdenum, manganese, zinc. And by utilizing the water present in the soil and the carbon dioxide, they convert it to oxygen. And a benefit for the cyanobacteria in Mars regolith is that they produce a geomicrobiological crust. So this allows a consolidation of the sand particles and the minerals, and it helps to survive in high sand winds, and it helps to colonize other microorganisms. So this other like such as different bacteria are there, and that bacteria uses this cyanobacterial biofilm for the getting the nutrients by lysing it. And this cyanobacteria produces bioactive components, and this bioactive components helps the heterotrophic plants to have a good yield, because these bioactive components will increase the crop yield, and it gives a nourishment to the soil. And the another interesting fact is that this cyanobacteria produces biofuels, especially dihydrogen and a monopropellant H2O2. And especially if we are doing a genetic engineering, it can also produce ethanol, which is also industrial important. And one important thing, this thing is that the cyanobacteria produces good bioedible biomass, which can be used as a nutrient product for astronauts or future people who are going to colonize. And so do you think genetic engineering is important, or it will help the biological life support system better? So my answer is yes, because a basic concept of genetic engineering is nothing but the transfer of genes from one organism to another. So if one organism can survive in such a condition, the organism which have the ability can has a specific genes. From that genes, we can incorporate into our control bacteria and can produce, and it became a super species. For example, like everyone knows Thanos, right? So Thanos has a lot of like 5 stones are there, or 6 stones. So if Avengers have different stones, and they can fight with Thanos if Thanos has all the stones. So we are like creating a Thanos. Yeah, that's the biggest like simple example for genetic engineering. And if we create a good microalgae which can survive in every condition, like all the extraterrestrial space conditions, they will be producing high like good like the survival of this microalgae will help them
Jovel, it's okay. Take a deep breath. How many slides do you have left?
Yeah, this is the second last. This microalgae helps the biological life support system for air revitalization, which is nothing but the uptake and production of air. And it has a good capability for the photosynthesis. So how much increase in photosynthesis will help to a large production of biomass. And this biomass, if it is edible, it can be used as food source. And if we manipulate such enzymes, for example, like lycopene catalase, it helps the production of carotenoid. And this carotenoid has some good effects for retina. And this acts as a shield for solar radiation. And there's an enzyme called Rubisco, which is present in C3 plants. So it has a, like how much upregulation of Rubisco, that much effect will be there for the plant to synthesize. And at last, if the cyanobacteria has a ability to take the inorganic salts or minerals directly from the Mars, like if it has a good leaching capacity, then it will be better, because like most of the nutrients are not present in the surface. It will be present in the inside the rocks. So if the cyanobacteria will not be able to have a dwelling capacity, then it can't be survived. So we have to focus on that. And application, as I already mentioned, they have a good shielding capacity in radiation, and they maintains a good temperature in the biological life support system, which is nothing but astronauts live. And algal oil and macular pigment, which helps a shielding, act as a shielding effect for the humans, and the production of biofuels, because if we can produce more biofuels in Mars or like different planets, for it will be very helpful for long-term space missions, because like transporting some fuels from Earth to different planet, it always costs economically. And if we can make this type of biofuels, it can solve some economical issues. And it also helps to produce bioactive molecules, which has a great importance in increasing the crop yield. And some statistical scientists says that algae can make the Mars or different planets terraform. But in practically, it is not possible because in it will take a lot of time. First of all, we have to find, is there any microorganism and how they survive and everything. So, but theoretically, it is possible because if they can change the atmosphere by all production of oxygen and consumption of carbon dioxide, it is possible actually. And symbiotic association of the bacteria and the plant, they can help in many ways to change the Mars or any other planet to Earth-like atmosphere. And my conclusion is, my aim of this project was how to make a good plant-associated microbial system to help the humans for colonizing in different planets, or like how it will be helpful for long interplanetary space missions, because carrying food from Earth to International Space Stations or transport, it will cause so many economical problem. And why can't we make a agriculture system in space so that we can get the product and without costing a lot of money? It will be very helpful. And I already said there will be medical benefits because microalgae has shown a lot of effect on shielding of you in UV radiations. So it will be also helpful. And
thank you, Jovan.
Thank you very much. These are my main reference. Yeah.
We don't have time for questions, unfortunately. If you have any questions for Jovan, please ask them in the chat.